This is a first of its kind, an autonomous system, all electric, in the United States, on an island in the middle of the ocean, against the odds.
The project that we are constructing here in Honolulu, the 20-mile system that goes all the way from the west side of the island to the east side, we are making history. Nothing this large has ever been done.
In its entirety, it's 20 miles. 21 stations.
We're on an old volcanic island, so the geology is a lot different here. The soil conditions are a lot different. The biggest challenge with this project is, and the fact that it's a mega project, right? It's $10 billion, but we're in the middle of the Pacific Ocean.
So that's your first challenge. That challenge lends itself to challenges with logistics, be it resources, be it materials, concrete, steel, on an island with limited resources that have to be brought in from the mainland or from across the world.
We had 2,700 individual segments, 210 spans, but everything was built at the precast yard. The precast yard itself is a mega project in a mega project. It's a 34-acre site. Last July, we opened up segment one. That was 10 miles of guideway and 9 stations. And then segment two is gonna be operational next year.
Stantec is our construction, engineering, and inspection consultant. And was very instrumental in helping us open that first segment. Getting us to opening was huge, and it was very difficult, but Stantec helped us to get over that finish line.
Because of the aging infrastructure, you know, 50, 75 years old, you know, a lot of the utilities are gonna be replaced. Taking the overhead utilities underground does help in, you know, storm prevention. You know, we have hurricane, tropical storms every season here.
We're doing utility relocations in the magnitude of $1 billion, whether it's underground utilities, overground utilities, high power, high voltage, the impact of construction is always going to be there. If you live in a community and there's construction going on, you know what that impact is. Our goal and what we've really strived to do with HART is minimize that impact.
Working on a transformational project such as this, you know, it takes a lot of stakeholder coordination. We had up to 40 additional stakeholders that we had to coordinate with between Department of Health, Department of Transportation, Highways Division, Airport Division, Army Corps of Engineers. It's like a very environmentally sensitive state, one of the most environmentally sensitive states in the U.S. So, you know, having to coordinate with all the different third parties for environmental coordination, coordinating the guideway construction over 4 sensitive waterways. We have our environmental compliance documents, but our programmatic agreement, our environmental impact statements. So it's making sure that those commitments that we've made to the community are getting incorporated into design plans.
One of the things we wanted to do was, here's a beautiful program, first of its kind in Hawaii, and we wanted to make sure that the resources that live here had an opportunity to work on.
We've hired 30% local firms, which is well above the 13% federal regulations. So we're committed to providing our local firms ability to learn as well on this project.
I feel really good about the players that have come together and everybody's been able to work together. They get, I think more than anything, the sense of responsibility we've all had in trying to make this a reality, a successful reality.
Our relationship with HART has really thrived throughout this long period of time for a couple of reasons. The first reason would be a commitment. And that commitment from our senior leadership to maintain consistent leadership on our side of it, but also to maintain that connection with HART senior leadership at the CEO level to make sure that their expectations and their goals are being focused on by all of the entire team.
I'm a very difficult leader to work for, especially if you're a consultant. And you can ask Brian and Scott, they will get emails, texts, or phone calls from me, and I am thoroughly impressed with those two gentlemen. And it's not just the responsiveness, it's the response itself. For example, the original design of the columns going down in the downtown areas, the Stantec team was able to optimize the column locations and saved HART and the taxpayers tens of millions of dollars. And I foresee that going on. We just awarded the City Center Guideway Station contract, and Stantec is very instrumental in the negotiations with the contractor, how we put that package together.
We're an island and in the middle of the ocean, and so the roadways are somewhat limited in that regard. I think we've always had dense traffic, but with the advent of a rail system, it began to open up people's imaginations and possibilities.
I'm very proud to be working on this project and making a change for the taxpayers, for the community, giving another transportation option.
It's not been an easy road, but that's okay, because what it's accomplished for this island, what it's accomplished for the residents of Hawaii, the visitors to Hawaii, really highlights what every project should be like if you really want to see something that changes the world.